Hello everyone. This is part 3 video tutorial how to create drop-down menu using Java Swing. And this video we going to create style of this menu. So first style we create is, draw the menu vertical line. Now go to menu item class, and override method paint component to create graphics. Here we draw the menu line if length not 0, it mean this menu item is the submenu. Set the color line. Then draw the line, the location start from top to bottom. And draw one small horizontal line. So here at the last menu, we draw only half of the menu height. So we need create condition here. If submenu index equal 1, this is the first menu item. And if submenu index equal length subtract 1, it is last menu item. So next we create the arrow button for every main menu have submenu. But we see the menu is show at the left side, so now move it to the right side. By use method translate. So next we going to make animation. Then go to menu animation class and use method setAnimate. Back to menu item class. In method paint component, we need change values location of path 2D arrow. But we need use method repaint to update graphics. Call it in menu animation class. But the arrow draw not smooth, so now we need use graphics rendering hint to make the draw line in subpixel. So next we going to create menu item ripple effect. Here ripple effect class that I have show you at the first part, now let use it. Change ripple effect color here, by use method set ripple color. Then here to render effect. So next we going to create submenu item drop shadow. Create buffered image for shadow image. Then create method to create shadow image. Use class shadow render to make shadow image. So we need update or create new shadow image when component size change, so we need created in method set bound. Then draw the buffered shadow image to the component, we draw it first menu item and the last menu item. Next we going to create menu event when user click. Create new class interface as menu event. Then go to menu class and create this event. Here for main menu item has click, so we call event when it no have any submenu. And here for submenu item has click. So now we can set event to this menu in main JFram class. And thank you everyone for watching. See you next video.